God has given me a lot of opportunities to work with the youth. From being a youth leader in Youth for Christ when I was in college, to being a missionary to the young in Sapampalay and Payatas as a Jesuit scholastic. From organizing the local branch of the worldwide network of the Eucharistic Youth Movement, to ministering to the sacramental needs of the children in conflict with the law in the New Bilibid prisons as a newly ordained Jesuit priest. And for the last 4 years, I have been doing campus ministry work at the Ateneo Junior High School. In all those years, bearing the responsibilities of those various roles, there were many lessons I learned. But the one that sticks is the importance of listening. It is only by listening with the heart that I have been able to carry out meaningful conversations with young people. Conversations through which I was blessed by God to be His instrument, to rekindle the hope in the hearts of the young, despite the many challenges that they are facing in this modern world. These challenges are difficult and daunting to the young. Domestic violence, poverty, single-parent household, lack of proper education, human trafficking, sexual exploitation, forced labor, substance abuse, and mental health issues such as depression and increase of suicide cases. And this pandemic has made the situation even worse for them. Being the vulnerable sector of the society, they can only rely on us for our guidance and help. Pope Francis, in his apostolic exhortation to the young people, said that we should be a listening church to the youth. As we celebrate the 500 years of the conversion of St. Ignatius, the Society of Jesus is taking on the same urgent challenge to pay attention to the needs of the young people by walking with them side by side and listening to them with our hearts.